Hello, hello. So, I'm just about to go live with this. I've no idea what it's like, but it looks good. It looks very good. This is a new horror survival game. Hopefully the stream is all good. It looks like it's running clean. Probably have to pause the game off a few times to set up my G13. I'm not a good player on keyboard. The Logitech G13 suits me a whole lot better. Now this though looks beautiful. Let's go and look at the options to see what we've got here.
Von Sawyer.
Bonsoir. What's up, Cotton? I love the way it pronounces it, Bon Sawyer. Look at that. Fuck me, that looks beautiful. Just put the ultra settings on. This has got partial controller support. Tempted to try it with a controller. Let's just have a look at the key bindings. General. Auto save on 5 minutes. Field of view. Reticule. Head bob. Strafing. It's got head tilt, controller, and mouse as well. Oh my word. Tutorial text on. Leave that for the moment. Key bindings. Okay, I'm gonna very quickly set up a few things on.
Sorry if I missed things. I had a minute delay on the direct live.
Oh, no. It's all good. I haven't done anything yet. I am quite literally, I'm going to have to set up the G13 as I'm going. So don't worry about that. I'm dead excited for this one. Okay, let's fire up the G13 software. This is going to be on my C drive in the Steam directory, so as soon as that's finished loading, I will go and set up a profile for it. There we go. Right, Pamela, choose application. It's got to be in my Steam directory, I guess.
What I liked on the cinematics earlier is it's a nice clean world in sunlight.
Yeah, it looked beautiful, didn't it? It looks like it goes night time as well, though, by the looks of it. Steam, Steam apps, common. Pamela, here we go. Pamela application, excellent. That was easy to do for once. Okay.
It reinforced the loss feeling emo.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I thought. Alright, so I'm just assigning some keyboard commands to my Logitech. You know I'm not very good on keyboard. So that's the movement keys. Sprint is left shift as per usual. So I'm going to put that on. What's jump? Has it got a jump? Jump's normally space, but yeah. Okay, jump is space, so I'll have that one. Crouch is control as per usual. Okay. Let's see what might be important. We'll have something called an arm menu. I think I'm going to need melee. Interact is E, I put that there. Punches on the mouse. Melee, ready your weapon, and aim is on the mouse already, that's good. Let's put the inventory up the top.
BRB Kofi.
Okay. If anyone's joining in, enter the stream. This is a new horror survival game called Pamela. It's an early access at the moment, so it's not a full game at the moment, but it looks fucking awesome. It looks really good. I'm just setting up a Logitech G13 keyboard. Be a couple of minutes before I'm ready to play the game. If you just have a little patience with me, I'll be there in a minute. If you're watching this back on YouTube, I apologize for the delay. You can fast forward a few minutes to when I'm finished doing this. AVG, I don't know what IVG is. I'm trying to program up some keys here so before I can launch the game. If you're coming to my channel expecting a flashy, completely rendered, completely set up, pre-set up and pre-made videos, that's not what you get. I record live streams. That's all I do, is I live stream and I record the live streams. So what you'll get when I play the game is a completely honest first impression. You won't get anything pre-planned and faked. That's not how I work. It's not how I roll. So, I've no idea what an IVG is. Oh, I need that as a block button. Left alt. Like the block's going to be particularly important in this game. Status menu, Pamela menu, U and P. U is a status menu, P is a Pamela menu. So I've got interact, ability, block, jump, run, crouch. I've got movement key set up. I need a map and a data pad menu, M and L. Okay, nearly there. Last couple of keys to do. Got block status. What's up? What's up, God? I'm nearly there. Got all the keys bar three done, I think. Oh no. Flashlight and IVG. I don't know what a fucking IVG is. Might have to change some of these keys when, as I'm going along, but... no idea what these are, so I'm just going to set them up anyway. That's F, and that's flashlight. Bits on my mouse map. IVG. What's a fucking IVG? Any idea what that might stand for? It's the R key. I'll program it in and find out what it is. Right. IVG, flashlight, and then I've just got keys 1 to 3 to program. Which are, let's have a look. 4 attachment.
I have an idea, but I don't think it's relevant here, XD.
Yeah, probably not then. Let's hear your idea. Apparently I can have some attachments called fore attachment, dorsal attachment, and something else. I'll check what the other one is and find out what those are. Dorsal. One more key and I've got them all done. I've probably got them in all the wrong places, but we'll find out. Utility attachments, the last one. Key 3. Okay, looks like I'm ready to go. Set a colour for that so I know it's that one's live. I'll set that one bright red, I think. Oh, that looks mean on my keyboard. Good colour for a horror game. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to go live with a new horror game for 2017 called Pamela. Bring the music volume down a little bit. And away we go. Seems to be collecting a collection of cups up here. I need to get rid of them later. Power transmitters are the core of any temporary structure. They transfer power wirelessly from a central location to any number of items, including shields, turrets, and portable containers. Apparently this game is prone to crashing. Hey, what's up, whoever else is watching? Hi, hi. Just loading in for the first time into this game. Let's see how it is. Oh, it's loading. I'd say it's pretty bloody unresponsive if that's loading. Or has it crashed already? Do you know what? I think it's crashed. That's a good start. No, it hasn't. Ooh. Oh, it looks sweet. Running a bit laggy, a bit slow. But then that might be, so I've got it on ultra settings. This isn't the most powerful PC in the world. Okay, my keys that I've set up are not working, Alice, because I haven't selected the right profile. Give me a sec. Hold on. Dead space profile. Let's try that. No, that's not working either. In fact, nothing's working on it. Again. Give us a second. For some reason that's not working. All the keyboard stuff I've just set up has disappeared. What the fuck? No way. Alright, give us a second. Just spent ages setting this up and it's all disappeared. That's rather annoying. Just drop it. I can drag and drop these now, so it shouldn't take too long to set up. Spacebar for jump, shift for run there, control for crouch there, that's fine. Attachment. There, there. There, and done. Interact on that key. Flashlight on that, IVG on that. Map over there. Pause on that one. Arm menu, where's inventory? Inventory's there. See what I'm missing. Two more I'm missing. Data pad. There. Oh, I haven't got block on here. Let's move ability to that one. Block to that one. I'm missing one more thing. What have I missed? Inventory, IVG, map, Pamela. Status menu. Pamela menu and data pad. There we go. Right, hopefully that'll fucking hold this time because for some reason it dropped out. There we go, arm menu. Right, I've got a feeling I'm going to have to drop the graphics quality on this because look how slow that's running. I'll leave it for a second. This is quite cool. Okay, this is upgrades. Guidance doesn't work, whatever that is. Sensory. Nothing. Interact doesn't seem to work with that. I don't know what that is. Doesn't seem to do anything.
I want a survival horror game where I can play Chewbacca trying to survive against Wookiee's zombies in the Death Star. You have to scan things before you can interact.
Ah, okay. Well, thanks for the advice, dude. Zensliev, what's up? Welcome. I've literally just loaded this up. Looks like I'm going to have to drop the graphics quality, though. It's really, really slow for me. It doesn't feel smooth at the moment. Let's just bring that down to high. Just quickly see if it makes much difference. Right, so we'll scan things first using what? Pamela status armory. Trying to work out what scan is. Ah. I've just programmed up a fucking Arky and I can't work out what that is now. Thing is, I'm not playing on the keyboard, I'm playing it on a G13 keypad, the little thumbstick. Block ability, IVG. Status. Well, that's what it says is IVG. There we go. How do you use it? There we go. Okay, I've got that. So that's nothing then. Oh, it's fucking dark, isn't it?
Shortly after I awoke, I asked the technicians why I couldn't feel my hands. Their blank faces offered no answers.
Is that it? could do with a little more brightness on this. Brightness. Not there. I'm not sure it is here at all. No. It's like I'm given the brightness I'm going to play with, and that's it.
You do start with a flashlight. It's not great, but you find upgrades to it.
Okay. All right, so I've got a flashlight key set up. Let's she's just stood there dead. It's a bit weird. Can you scan people? Can I interact with that? Yes, I can. Nothing in there, that's why the cross. Okay. Does the flashlight run out of battery, do you know? Why she stood there? So take it you've got this one then. There's another one just stood there. What the fuck? These are AIs that have just stopped then. It's like sticking out their eyeball. I don't know what I'm picking up. What are these things? Let's have a look through the rest of my menus quickly while I'm getting going on this. Got a map. Fuck me. Logs are unlocked. Events. Encyclopedia. Nope.
Infinite flashlight. You do have energy, but it only gets used on weapons or when your shield gets hit. Fuck. Once you get a shield.
Okay. Thank you. How nice to have someone who knows what they're doing to come in at the stream. Okay, so what I was picking up there is Lux, and that's some sort of currency then. Statistics tutorial. Blah. Need to interact. How to equip Pandora IVG for searching the environment and repairing built objects. Okay, to switch IVG modes to search, build and repair. Game I didn't set T up on my keyboard, I don't think. Shall have to program that one in. How to scan the environment with the IVG. Combat. Left button to punch, right button to aim, T to switch. Are we going to switch weapon or not? I don't think I have. Set that up. T for switch weapons. I might have to program some of these onto my mouse instead, actually, as well. Probably be more useful. Left a block. I've got blocks set up somewhere. Yeah, I've got block on that. That's alright. Space, dodge and movement direction 3 to use utility key. Pamela abilities Q to select Pamela ability. Building things as well. To build a base, first collect a power transmitter and an ion core. You need to insert an ion core into the power transmitter. Open the IVG by pressing R, then press T to switch to build mode. Highlight a buildable object from the list and press middle button to select it, then left button to place it on the bulb. Place an ion core inside of the power transmitter to supply power to it, allowing it to build within a radius around the transmitter. Hold E when looking at buildable items to view radial interaction. That's the interact key. Okay. So that's that menu. We've got the data pad menu. That's what I was on. Okay. So all of those are available from the wrong button. All of those are available from your ARM menu then. What does it say over there? Scroll tab, scroll, select tab, left button, right. Inventory, in fact. Abilities I don't have yet. So I assume having this thing out at the moment is the most useful thing I can do. I did have a key though, is that going to work? Fuck that. Go away. No, I don't want to do the lock, go away. How do I stop that? Oh shit. I've no idea what I'm doing with the lock, I don't want to touch it yet. It's a very nice looking game. Right, that's the room I started in. Another one of these freaky looking things, this time with blood. Alright, so they're not cyborgs or something. Maybe they are cyborgs, so the human and machine interface. Fuck knows. Please enter a code. Have I got a code in anywhere yet?
You just have to get the timing down and click when the spinning thing is in the highlighted part of the ring. It does take some getting used to though.
Okay. What's the security response when it comes? That's what I'm wondering. I'm wondering if you get the key code out of that. Oh. Shit. I've shagged it up. Already. Oh, I can't get into that now. Oh well.
If you mess up down here, nothing happens because it's kind of a tutorial area. But once you're out, you can trigger robots that come to arrest you.
Right, so I don't have code for that. Okay. Possible contamination. Emergency broadcast. Garrison official. Alert. Possible widespread contamination. Many reports have been received in recent days that are indicating a possible affliction of unknown origin and effect. We are advising residents to remain within their home whenever possible and to maintain distance with all unnecessary individuals. ARC Medical and Biostera are currently investigating the scope of contamination and have asked anyone with these symptoms to report to a clinic. Migraines, fatigue, joint stiffness, abnormal growths. Nice. I ask that you please remain calm. Any and all illnesses will be quickly resolved once we discover the root cause of this incident. Okay. I'm glad it's got a tutorial phase in it, because I need it. Okay, that means it's empty. Buy things. A muffin. God knows how long that's been sitting there. Have I missed something? Is there something else I should have picked up? I could have sworn, looking at a little video I saw of this, somebody had picked up a shield or something by this point. You can dodge sideways. So Cecily, what do you think of this? Densely, F, sorry. Fuck is beeping. Double click auto pick up left on drag. I did double click. I switched to inventory, okay. Maybe some currency? No, it's not. Maybe in one of them. Putting my scanner away every time I open up a box or something. Come around to that room.
When you hear a beeping noise, it probably means you've dropped down a threshold level on either food or water.
Okay. I thought I was an AI in this. Oh, like that you mean? How do I work that out? I can hear something growling, making noises, don't like it. How do I know what's what on here? Status, health, energy, fatigue. It's all maximums. It's not what I'm after. Fuck knows.
On that main menu with the status, inventory, map, etc., if you look further to the left on your arm, you'll see your food and water.
Oh, okay. On the arm menu then. I can't seem to look further to my left. I don't know why not. Why is it not letting me do that? Something to do with my screen sizing or something. I can't actually get over to that section. Yeah, some of the screen seems to be missing off the side there. I wonder if that's something to do with the way I've got it set up. Into windowed mode for a minute. That's still the same. I can't see that section of the screen. What's that doing then? Why is that? I don't know what's going on with that. I can't actually see off to that side of the screen there.
It might just be bugging out and thinking you're zoomed in when you're not. Early access bugs and whatnot, I've had that happen once or twice myself. It goes away with a relug.
Okay. Do we have a save option, or is it just going to save automatically? Yeah. Let's try it and see. So Zensliff, are you just a player, or are you one of the devs on this game or something? It's not uncommon for the devs to come into a game when they see someone streaming it. did say it's got partial controller support. I'd be much happier playing on the controller, but then I have to use my keyboard for the other bits. See what it's like on controller. Got one plugged in. All the controls, the other controls programmed onto it all. And see, that feels better. Let's work out.
Just a player, but I was following this game since preview trailers first went out. Love the setting as such a change of pace from the usual brown-gray Russia apocalypse that survival horror seems to have gotten stuck in lately.
Yeah, agreed. Oh, look. It's crashed. Doesn't seem to like me using the controller. Yeah, I've had a crash. Have you had much problem with it crashing? Maybe not, maybe it's back. That is back, cool. Right, let's see what the buttons on the controller do, if anything. Down is flashlight. A is jump. Left stick for run. Right stick for crouch, that's cool. Now my arm doesn't have the arm menu on it.
It's definitely a memory hog, especially when you're first loading in. Not too many crashes, especially with the latest patch.
Right, that's something going on with my arm. I'm starving. I'm trying to use it. Doesn't want to double click. So one more thing. Flux, the archetypal drug of Nirvana. Mysterious in its origin, it increases agility and clout for a time before inducing withdrawal. Ah, so you can use drugs, but you get withdrawals. Medical jackal, tray fatigue and health. And pain from bone fracture and other things. It wears off after a period of time, but you don't get addicted to morphine. Well, that's an unusual one. I don't know if you find things in the bogs or not. Toilets. That's the bar I was behind. Is there an interact key on the keyboard? Yeah.
The permit state is to further research the decaying genetic material found in residence.
Oh. There
was a pretty hilarious glitch in earlier versions where one random item would spawn infinitely in a random container, spilling out of it onto the floor, so, if you ever entered that area, your frame rate would drop to a crawl because they're all physics objects.
Oh, okay. There we go. Lol. Yeah, pretty much every survival horror type game I've been looking at on Steam or G2A lately has all been set in a kind of brown, grey Russian environment, right? Scan or get anything off of these things. Still know something there then. Right. More drugs. There's plenty of drugs in the place. Want a party, you're alright. Done that one. It's quite easy to get yourself all turned around here in the dark, isn't it? I feel like I've missed something. Alright, follow the left wall. Nothing. Okay. I should be able to pull up the armor menu and work out what button it is again. Oh, what the fuck's that? That's changing mode. So that's buildables. Okay. Fucking hell. Little way, right. Trying to work out to get my bloody arm. Right, so now I've got the arm thing, but I have no. I'll do that one. Ah, here we go. So there's my health, food. Power, okay. Yeah, that's working now at least. Cryo storage key card added. Okay, that was back here. I swear that was back here. I just don't know where. Oh man, I'm totally lost. Right back where I started. Okay, that's no good. There's a fucking map. Piss off. That's kind of not that much help to me because I actually don't know where I am in relationship to Oh, this looks better. Is it around here?
Yeah, the map is kinda useless if you don't already know the general lay of the land.
Yeah, I'm just finding that. Best way here is just to stick to the right hand wall, I think. See what I come to. Alright, I recognise this then, that's better. Hang on, it says code 0712. Is that because I've got the card? Did it say that already and I just didn't read it? Right, the fucking door then. IVG storage upgrade, okay.
No, it only says that once you get the corresponding card.
Security bypass. Security bypass plus, that's got to be useful. That looks like drugs. Nope. Is that everything? It appears the controller button doesn't work for... Oh, I'm running low on food. Now where the fuck am I? So have you heard much about the story mode that's coming with this?
And the cyanotrope begins to glow faint blue. I'm reminded that only a day, not a decade, has passed.
Okay, there's people or something here. First encounter. Man, now my mouse pointer is gone. Yep. It's lagged out. Thermal pump compound. Energy cell. Well, that's going to be useful to start building things then. Right now, though, I'm more worried about getting some food and water. Or a starve.
I've tried to avoid learning too much about the story besides what you can learn in game. Trying to guess what went so horribly wrong is half the fun.
I didn't know if they, because it says what I read about it, that they're not offering any information about story yet, but it'll come later. That. Oh, water. And I got good spare as well. I've got the IVG storage upgrade. So I just upgraded it permanently or something. Not one was fertile, it was a food. This is hydroponic farms, but I can eat it. I don't know if I can eat that or not. Oh, bollocks. Ah, fuck you. Oh, I think I'll best go back and check through this gate quickly. Wow, there's a lot of bodies out here.
The gate's actually the right way to go. You'll want to check the other way first.
Oh, okay. I did wonder because the gate had a lock on it. Now I'm confused as to which one was the gate. Hang on, let's find the... This is it, I think. Oh, now I'm fucking confused. Alright. That was the gate. Now what? Okay, there was the gate, that's the way I need to go. You don't get another chance at unlocking these then, by the looks of it. Oh yeah? Oh, fuck you.
You do. They refresh after a little while.
Cool. Shit. I see what you mean about it being a little tricky. Not so bad as it on the controller as it was on the mouse, though. You still there, Cotton? You're very quiet tonight. With all the darkness in this game, I can see it proper scaring the shit out of me. Hello, mate. Oh. How dare you? Hmm. Some stuff for me, where is it? Firehouse whiskey, nice. You get drunk and a NutriCube. I need something to drink, so no longer dehydrated. Have another look at my arm. Well, that's a bit better.
Also, just as a combat tip, you can hold down your attack button to sort of wind up for a slower but more powerful punch.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Yeah, I can see this game proper scaring the crap out of you when something really comes at you and you're not expecting it. Because it is so dark. Ooh, what have I got? Butcher's Blades. Ooh. Nice, I think. T to switch weapons. I did put a weapon button on. Can't even see what's going on now. I don't know if I've got the blade. Oh, I have. Alright, is that it? I think that's everything. Oh, fuck it. I'll get there one day with that. There's actually a box back in the first area I could have had another go at opening as well then. Okay, look at this lot. Bodies everywhere. Right, I'm going to go left walled, I think. Bring my map up. Probably a good idea to have the map out where you get used to it. Thank you. I've got to find a key for that one.
In my experience, things in locked containers aren't usually game-changingly awesome. Just like, more money than you'd normally find or more filling food, etc.
Pull that back up saying, in my experience, things in locked containers aren't usually game-changingly awesome, just like... Okay. Well, the money's still going to be useful, isn't it? Does it list that in your inventory, how much cash you've got? Oh, now what? Gonna be on low on food again. No, not yet.
Containers that say garrison are the exception because they usually have weapons, shields, armor parts, or things like that. You should always try to crack those open when possible.
Okay. That's some cash. It's worth hanging around for those then.
Originally, Jacob would converse with me every day, even insisting on being called my creator. I only understood the concept years later.
There's something that... I'll work out how this controller's working. Doesn't appear to be doing what you expect. Seat packing. So you can find a hydroponics farm and grow food. That sounds a bit. Can I become alcoholic? I appear to be getting a lot of booze. We are all infected. This last bar.
Unfortunately, from the item descriptions, it's like Star Trek alcohol, synthesized for the flavor but with none of the actual intoxication.
Right, enhanced temporal formula. Following the recent analysis of emotional trends and stress factors, it's been decided to further improve the current temporal formula. In order to achieve this, both Art Medical and Biostera are currently collaborating. Seeing as the formula was originally invented in the early 2200s, this will mark over 3 decades since the original invention and introduction. Great strides have been made since its original iteration. Hang on, I need a drink. increasing the effectiveness from 32 to 74%. What the fuck? The fucking hell is that? The fuck is it? Scanning it didn't seem to do any good.
Those are just observers.
Fucking annoying. Try and finish my reading then. Increase the effectiveness from 32 to 74%. However, given the recent riot and the promenade last month, we are investigating adding a mild sedative to the formula to temper advanced stages of frustration. There are concerns about potential for withdrawal following cessation of taking the temporal formula. Vice Chair Alex assures us a non-issue. Residents are heavily encouraged to keep doses consistent. A resident did skip a dose, the flooding of emotions may prove to be debilitating. A person in such state would immediately be recognised by seekers and removed for rehabilitation. This outcome would further enforce the dependence on temporal, but it is critical for a peaceful society. Basically, they were drugging the entire society then.
If you do anything illegal, hacking locks or hitting them, you might get targeted as hostile by the bigger bots though, so be careful.
Oh, okay, so going around smacking it is not going to help much, so. Okay, each draw is individual on these things then, looks of it. Yeah. What's that? Upgrade cell. Multiverse perceived technology that unlocks the latent potential in various attachments. Where's it gone? Hang on, where did it go? I'm a little confused by that.
If they don't help you in case of zombie aggression, does that mean that zombies' attacks are legal?
I have no idea where that thing went then.
You go to your butcher's blade on the right and switch from description to upgrades, you can spend those points.
Ah, I see. Doesn't even, you couldn't actually read that there was upgrades there. Quite dark. How do I know how many points I've got? Okay. I don't know how I knew how many points, supposed to know how many points I had. that's a window.
There are the blue, pink, and orange dots in that little window between the middle and upper inventory screens.
Thank you. I'm going to shut this bloody noise away. I'm heading upstairs now. This could be a bit more dodgy.
You're either starving or dehydrated right now, BTW.
I'm probably starving then. Yeah, I'm starving. I don't think I've got anything to eat. Nope. Is that going to help me? Nope. Is that going to help me? Nope. I'll look around for a likely place to find food quickly. Oh, Jesus. You don't last long without your food, do you? Alright. Time is of the essence then. Okay, I'm gonna have a quick smoke before I start again. This is quite eerie. I like it. It's got a really kind of eerie, dark feeling to it. The sound effects and the soundtrack is quite useful for making that work. So how far have you managed to get in it?
Death isn't necessarily a bad thing in this game though. That XP you get you can spend on genetic upgrades when you respawn.
Genetic upgrades, how do you do that? I'm exceptionally glad you stopped in, I'll tell you that. Where are you from, though?
Go to start a new game. Ah. It'll take you to a menu to spend any points on before you pick where to respawn.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so where are you from? I keep forgetting there's a big stream delay going on. I don't know why. It seems to be quite an awful amount tonight.
I'm in Florida in the US.
Oh, okay. Nice part of the world. As long as you're okay with gators and snakes. Oh, I couldn't believe that you had that gator in the lake.
Slowly sweating to death.
Is it that warm there already? Jesus. Alright, I should be back in a minute. I've got a nip for a quick smoke. Won't be long.
Nearing 3-3C these days. Wow. -14 degrees Celsius during the day for today here.
Nearly 33 degrees, bloody hell.
Grew up in the north.
Over here in the UK, it's all right during the summer. We get temperatures up to 32, 33 maybe. Springtime temperatures in the 20s. Which it's been during the day, it's been about that, I guess, 18, 20 degrees. Oh, that is working. Just can't work out which button on the controller it is to make it bloody work. Funnily enough, none of the controller buttons actually seem to work on that. Neither does that though. What the hell? I'm using the mouse and it's not working. Oh, I've got to use the enter.
19 in Normandy XD.
Is that where you are, Cotton, Normandy? Okay, so I have one unspent genome point. Superior hemoglobin. I want some. Does it tell you what? Ah, okay, nice. So you're further south than me then, so you probably get warmer weather than me. That's your fatigue.
You can only pick from the top two to start with. You unlock more as you continue to level up.
Uh-huh. That's vendor discounts. I'm better off with hemoglobin to start with, I guess. It doesn't seem to like...
It's the Normandy XD. It's raining half the time or it's cloudy.
Yeah, well, I live in England, so tell me about rain. Why is that not working? Confirm points, but... Okay. The controller seems very strangely laid out. Okay, so this time, let's get a shift on with it. Flashlight. Oh, yeah, that was it. Can't remember where everything was.
OBTW, as for how far I've gotten, there's no surefire way to keep yourself supplied with food. You can get water condensers for infinite water, but even growing food depends on finding seeds and fertilizer out in the world. So once you've searched most areas, it starts to get impossible to keep fed.
Jesus. This is a real challenge, then.
Every death makes you retrooting from the very beginning?
No, you had a chance to respawn from somewhere else, it showed. But further on. Oh god, it's moving on this one. Fuck you. Oh, that's the room I started in. Tonal silencer. Simple mechanized chant makes the user lighter on their feet. Used by those.
If you manage to find a cryo core and bring it to one of the cryogenic space throughout the city, you unlock the ability to spawn there.
Okay. So I can sneak with that, okay. Yeah, that's the room I came in. Or is that, that's the room I get. Fucking confused now again. That's the room I came in.
Other than that and genetic upgrades, you start over from scratch each time.
Once you've got one of these cryo things, does it, is it stay there for each, every game? Or do you have to find it each time?
Which can suck when you've made a really nice base of operations for yourself. No, once you've unlocked a new bay, you've unlocked it for good.
Okay, well that's useful at least. Seems to randomly spawn stuff as well.
Shortly after I awoke, I asked the technicians why I couldn't feel my hands. The blank faces offered no answers.
Sorry, it's 4 a.m. here and I'm starting to hear the call of my bed.
That's alright, Cotton. Take it easy, man. Thanks for stopping by. As per usual, you didn't stop by. You spent the whole day here, mate. Yeah, it's good, isn't it? I'm still fractionally confused by it. How do you do this? F, maybe. E, sorry. Fertilizer, okay. Yeah, you have a good night. Why does it say how much money you've got on it? It doesn't, does it? Oh yeah, Lux balance 60, I see.
I've punched those screens so many times. Using the E key is so counterintuitive.
Isn't it?
Have a good game and enjoy it.
Thank you, Gordon, yeah. If you're about, I will, if I'm on during the day tomorrow, which I doubt I will be. I will catch you tomorrow, otherwise I will see you the day after, if you're about. This is definitely going to take me some getting used to. It's even worse if you're actually playing it on the controller as well. Because it doesn't seem to be a interact key on the controller. Unless I've just missed it.
Yet, I haven't tried playing on a controller, so I'm afraid I can't help there.
Right, can I open something up with that? I can press that and it gets to use or equip, but I can't seem to just transfer it into my inventory with that. Do that again. See, damn, that immediately makes you eat it. Use it, sorry. I don't mind using that. Right, I'm full of food.
The mouse, if you right click, it'll automatically transfer it to your inventory.
Yeah, I've kind of been switching between the mouse and the. See, the movement is better if I'm using the joystick of the left hand, like the joypad part on my left hand, and the mouse for the direction.
A new wing was added to ARC Medical. The permit states it is to further research the decaying genetic material found in residents.
Right, so that's for the cryo storage, which is, let's see if I can get this right this time. Right past toilets. Oh god, am I running low on drink already? Don't drink anything else for the moment. Eight, one, six, seven. Right, stuff randomly spawns in, because I've got different... But some bits the same, some bits not.
Oh, one interesting part of survival that they don't really teach you is that each section of the city has its own power management. It's generally good practice to find the nearest power terminal in a new area and turn off power completely, so you'll have it when you need it for something.
Okay. I haven't even encountered one in here yet, I don't think.
It means wandering around in the dark a lot, but even emergency power eventually runs out and then you'll be stuck in the dark anyway.
Okay. I'm not sure if I've covered everything out here or not. I don't think so. No. That one I think I did. No, maybe not. Salmon jerky. I'm back to there, what the fuck?
You'll know a power terminal when you see one. They look like a very narrow payphone on a wall.
Okay. Alright, let's just check there's anything down here. Don't know if everything's in the same place every time or not. What does that say? I don't know what I got then. Oh, that's the impact catalyst. I have no idea. It's something... No. It just goes there, doesn't it? Primary ability converts 10% player damage into energy if health is below 50%. Spec 1 doubles conversion, okay.
It's extra energy storage.
Oh, okay. Doesn't seem very self-explanatory, does it, when you're reading the descriptions and that? Oh. I take it I shouldn't attack the robot dude. Just ignore him. He seems to be a bit stuck.
Yeah, definitely don't attack robots.
Yeah, there's quite a few of them as well. They weren't here last time. Just ask you, what about attacking
whenever the sun rises and the cyanotrope begins to
people around the robots? Do you get in trouble for that?
Only a day, not a decade, has passed.
Because there's a person by these robots somewhere. Yeah, look. If I attack him, am I going to get in trouble?
You don't need to worry about junk items, BTW. I think there are plans on making them sellable, but right now they do nothing.
Okay. So that last one I picked up was useless.
To attack the people, just be careful about accidentally hitting the robots as you do.
Oh fuck, 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 fuck. Am I going to get in trouble for leaving this then?
Oh, they want to arrest you for something.
No, 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 open. Oh, fuck. Alright, I'm in trouble. Fucking don't hit me then, tosser.
I honestly don't know why they wanted to arrest you.
I don't know.
That observer before, but that was in a past life, so unless there was a glitch, they shouldn't remember that.
Yeah, I didn't do anything wrong, did I? So, I don't know. Probably do with a drink. I've gone too far. I probably need to go back and search this area first. It's one of the observer things. Do about that. Junk. Okay, I can just leave the junk for now then. I wonder if they'll randomise the spawn points of all this stuff, because at the moment it's all the same.
Originally, Jacob would converse with me every day, even insisting on being called my creator. I only understood the concept years later.
It's actually quite nice to...
Each time you respawn, the loot should all be different.
Yeah, it seems to be. I think it's actually quite nice to press the button on that fucking things on the wall so you can actually hear a human voice. Ah, jump over that.
No spoilers, but her story is really intriguing so far.
Okay, cool. Go away. So we've got a set of stairs up there. All missing people boards. State of emergency.
There should be a power terminal in this room.
There's a box there. Oh, it's a coffin, isn't it, outside? Go. So I've turned it off now, or have I? Yeah, I've turned it off. I think. Or it was off already.
Yeah, it's off.
It looks fucking lovely. Right, someone over there.
It won't regain power, but it won't drain either, and you can turn it back on when you want to shop from a computer terminal or something.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Okay, before I go out this end passage then, to go back and finish around this side of the room. Bring my map up so I can see where I am exactly. Another set of stairs. Oh, that's just a picture. I thought that was actual real life greenery. I'm getting confused where I am again.
When an area does run out of power, there's one main terminal for each area where you can request more power from the city's power plant. Those will look like angular gray boxes on the wall that open up when you get close.
Okay. I'm so glad you stopped in. I'd have been still trying to suss most of that shit out, believe me. That's better. Oh, it's not an elevator.
LOL, no worries. I love the game, so I'm glad to help someone else enjoy it too. I know it can be tough to get into when you're flying blind.
Yeah.
The tutorial leaves a lot to be desired.
Oh, there's a tutorial? I didn't even see that. What do you mean, the like, little bit of text that was at the top? But you couldn't really call that a tutorial, could you? It was awful. Try that again. Right, it's locked. Give it a minute, see if it catches up, but at the moment it's locked out.
Yeah, those little text pop-ups that basically tell you the button presses.
That's the tutorial. Okay, yeah, it does leave a lot to be desired. Oh dear. Oh, there we go. Got out of it. Okay, so that's the power box. I think I've done everything around there. And that'll take me back the way I came in. So, to go upstairs. That appears to be empty.
If you go up the stairs, the path to the left when you are facing the windows will lead you to this area's main power terminal.
Level 1 Ward A. I'm in a hospital. It's rather spooky playing this low light condition all the time, isn't it? Cyano tubes require cyano repair kit. Okay. Scan that already.
Oh, Those damaged tubes can be repaired to boost power efficiency in the area. The same is also true for using maintenance keys on battery backups you will find sooner or later.
Ah, main power station, there we go. Okay, yeah, things operate at 50% efficiency at the moment, I see. So I'm in the Arc Med District. Right. Getting better at that. An ion core, ooh, nice. I can use those to build things, I believe, can't I?
I asked about the deep frame again. I was told that I had been mistaken, that no such thing exists. Jacob seemed disappointed.
I need a drink. I don't think I've got one. Nope. That seems a hell of a lot easier than it was on the mouse. Okay, well, I don't have to use those points now. I can wait for that. And now, yet again, I'm lost.
Most building items need power to operate, but it's worth mentioning that storage pods don't. When you're first starting out and you're lucky enough to find one, they make fantastic backpacks. They have their own much larger inventory inside, so you can place one down, put stuff you won't need right away in it, then zap it back into your inventory, taking up a fraction of the space.
Okay, storage pods, I guess. Alright. I've got this fucking torch on. God, it almost seems ineffective, doesn't it? Someone somewhere.
You'll find attachments that widen the flashlight beam, make it reach further, or a happy medium of both.
That's cool. Well, I've already got a lot further than the first play. Then, to be fair, I didn't actually have a fucking clue what I was doing on that one. Let's check down here a minute. I think that's where I came into the place up there, I think. Not. No, maybe not.
Or torch. Sorry, I forgot to translate to British.
Right, it's a flashlight, that's fine. Okay, I've got the same thing again. So they're both the same. I guess that's sellable. Toxicity scan.
At the moment you can't sell anything, so feel free to drop duplicates or things you just don't want.
Oh, okay. And drink as much alcohol as you want. Because it don't do shit all to you. I was assuming there'd be a door into this bar place somewhere. It's got to be somewhere. Fuck you. I guess he hasn't got anything to take. Oh, don't make me jump.
There's an entrance around the backside, near the elevator.
Ah, but I need a code. That's the elevator then. Yeah, and that's the side where I was. Oh, that's powered down because I've got the power off, I guess. And back to some stairs.
Not sure where to find the password for that door. The password locks are a recent update, and I haven't been spawning here lately.
Jacob is becoming increasingly thin. Emma anxiously tells him to rest. I agree.
If I turn the power on, that machine will start working, won't it? Now I'll leave it. I need a drink. That's a food. Oh.
Yep, those need power to function. Also, while I can't remember which ones are what, I know each shopping terminal is color-coded based on what they sell.
Oh, I hear someone. There we go. Oh, nice. Just what I needed. Well, that's not too bad. All my power's going down there. Shit. No! They look a bit plasticky, don't they? I hope they improve upon that, because they do look a bit plasticky, the people.
Your power's actually fine. You start out with 100 max, but that impact catalyst made your max 200, so it looks like you have half energy, but it's just the 100 you started with.
Right. Okay.
Jacob seems relaxed. He communicates intently with Hakan on the phone, smiling intermittently.
I'm not doing too bad this playthrough so far. I think so anyway. I've survived being attacked by robots. That feels pretty good. Does your wanted status last permanently or does it go away? Like, it goes away in between rounds, I know you said. It's supposed to, but yeah, I'm wondering whether it goes away during the actual round you're in. To the promenade to Origin Station. Okay. Map. Wrong button. That's not. It's my map. What's the wrong button?
I believe it goes away over time as well, but I'm not 100% sure. I usually just get arrested since there's no people left to stop you from walking right back out of the rehabilitation clinic.
Okay. I've already done that. I've got that door to go through, but I've still got this side to check out. I haven't done this as well. Alright, let's go through the door. Coming in now, you did. Fuck you. Nice though, I love that. Bit of health. At this point, I'm feeling pretty good. I seem to be doing all right. I've got plenty of food and water. Well, plenty. I've got some. Nothing. Nothing. Type bastards.
Also, as a rule of thumb, the more intact and human one of the zombies looks, the more difficult it is to kill.
Okay, that makes sense.
The glowing red arm attachment, those are the toughest in the game.
Okay. Come to the attention of the overseer. Many citizens I'd skip the morning shot. Why not? Why not strictly forbidden? It's highly encouraged. Do not lose faith in the stability we've enjoyed so far. Countless species degrade against such a state and must rise up against temporary eyes, no matter how trouble. Okay. It seems like this drug's caused the outbreak, doesn't it? That's what I'm gathering from this so far.
I met a seeker when maintaining the surveillance grid. We lost there during some routine repair work. I made some space for additional server for him.
Junk.
The ones with the arm attachments give their locations away by muttering and talking to themselves, and they're the only ones that actually talk, so it's easy to tell when they're nearby.
Fucking hell. Once the arm attachments give their locations away by muttering and talking to themselves, and they're the only ones that actually talk, so it's easy to tell, okay. Another machine. Oh, garrison. Subversive weapon. Multi-person HDM direct layer and can fire multiple types of projectiles, delivering poison, hallucinogenic, or tranquilizer compounds. Oh, what? He didn't have anything on him. Got it.
If you fire weapons too quickly, you'll damage yourself. Some can be fired more quickly than others, but that one has to be fired very slowly.
He's a bit aggressive, isn't he, over there? Beating the shit out of whatever it is he's beating the shit out of. I think that's an elevator.
Also, if zombies kill an observer, you'll see that happen a bit. You can loot the observer's body, but finding the prompt to loot it can be a bit finicky.
Okay. Oh, no, hang on. Nice.
You should put that helmet in your inventory on, BTW.
Helmet? No, I had one. Oh, Sana processor. That's for fixing the pipes in the wall, isn't it? Water cup. And another subversor, which I can't do anything with. Might as well leave that. Oh, in my inventory, yeah. Let's see what state of my food and drink is. Let's have a drink. I didn't give me that much in the way of drink, did it? At least some. Oh, he's killed two of these things.
No, the processor is junk.
Oh, is it?
The thing you're thinking of is a cyanotube repair kit.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I think everything else I've got is useful. Energy cell. Lots of money. Come on.
doctor readied me for making a mistake filing the official forms for Emma's eligibility certificate. I informed him that I could not have mistaken her genetic name. Not after all this time.
Dead end then. Was it, wasn't it? Yeah. Why not? Oh, Jesus. Doesn't actually realise I'm here, does it? No. Shit.
It's actually pretty easy to melee those guys when they're distracted by the observer because they'll keep focusing on the observer the moment you take a few steps back. But
okay.
Once the observer dies, they'll turn on you. Obviously.
Okay, so probably it's best to take him on when I had the observer to keep attention. They're actually quite simple to take down once you get used to them, aren't you? Oh, I've got no room in my inventory, I think. Oh no, I've got room. Fuck. Actually, while I'm here anyway. Need some health, food and water. junk. Let's drop that.
Sometimes your inventory space does get bumped even when you have spots free. I find if you just move something into the empty space and back out of it again, it'll remind the game that you have room there.
Oh, that's useful. Ooh. Used. Well, I'm just a little confused by that round room. There appear to be any switches. I can't put that in there. Let's see.
It's a step in the right direction. Those round rooms didn't even have any door mechanism to them a while ago. Now they have openable doors, but they just don't trigger properly.
Rooms didn't have any door mechanisms to them a while ago. Now they just don't trigger, okay. That thing is kind of useless to me unless I put it on while I'm at a shop. Just change over while I'm at a shop. It's taking up too much inventory space to keep, I think. I'm pretty much out of inventory space now. What time is it? Jesus, half past four in the morning already. Good job I ain't got to go anywhere quickly tomorrow. Dude, if you're in Florida, it's like half past nine in the morning. You've been up all night, haven't you? It's just another subversive, it's the same as what I've got, isn't it? It's a shame.
I have a terrible habit of being a night owl, even though my job frequently has me going to work at 5 a.m. Then I just sleep through half the day instead.
Yeah, I'm pretty much the same. I'm always up at night. Yeah, these aren't triggering at all. Oh, bloody hell. Alright. Now I found a shit ton of stuff. I can use a bit of food and water. I've thought of four more uses in that one. That's junk, I can drop that. That's a buildable. Food. Plenty of water. Iron core, I've got a shock trap, two shock traps, shock trap and a shock trap plus.
By the way, if you want a decent home base to start storing things in, there's a suite on the top floor of the area you're in now. You can take the elevator up there, that has a nice view and plenty of space, and enemies only rarely spawn inside.
So enemies actually respawn then, that's useful to know. I wasn't sure about that. Can you just drop stuff on the floor and it stays there? Yeah, if I go up to the top floor and drop shit, will it just stay where I dropped it?
Things that spawn on the floor stay there, but I think dropped items despawn after a certain length of time.
That's
never
a shame.
Actually tested it though.
Be worth a check then. Ah, oh, fuck. You had that one, but not quite.
You can put items in any existing containers in the environment, though.
Oh, that's useful. Shit. Alright, I'm pretty much out of space, so... A lot of adrenaline hypos. I'll just leave it there for now. Wow, what happened to my flashlight?
You should use one of those adrenaline hypos now. You're really low on stamina ATM, that circle in the middle when you sprint or punch at stuff.
Okay. Where's that show on here? I can't see. Time, lux balance. Oh, I've got 1,165 lux as well. Oh, fuck. Oh, come on. That seems to turn up when I'm trying to pick locks.
I'm not sure what your arrow keys are mapped to, but you do have a couple of security bypasses that will get you through one, two, or three layers when hacking.
Yeah, so that's what they're for then, is it? Okay. My arrow keys are on the left stick, the joypad, or on the thumbstick. Well, sorry, that's WASD. My arrow keys on the keyboard are just on the keyboard, on the ordinary keyboard. I come through this way or what? Now I'm confused. It's a big old space, isn't it? Yep, my badness has gone away, look. I didn't get done. Only 26 power in this one.
It took me ages to get around to the WASD configuration. I always used to map everything around the arrow keys till I kept running into games that wouldn't let me.
Well, I use a Logitech G13, so I've got a thumbstick on it, and then I've got 24 programmable keys or something, 26 programmable keys. So my thumb sits on the stick and my fingertips sit on the keyboard. But when I can use a controller, I use a controller, because I've been a console gamer for 20 odd years. Last time I played on a computer, I mean, I've only had this computer for about 2 months. I haven't had a gaming computer for, well, I've never had a gaming computer. The last computer I used for games was a Commodore Amiga back in 1990 something. So this has all changed for me, it's all different. I'm not used to it at all. Ooh, what have I got here? Is this a cryopod basing? Yeah. Now if I had power on, I'd be able to access that. But I've got the power off. But then I have to have a cryo thing to use that, don't I? Am I right? This could be a respawn point for me if I had the right stuff.
The place you are in now is actually a gene modding store.
Oh, is it? So I can pay to modify my genes. Another one. Oh, why is a key code?
You will find keys that unlock different gene mods that you can buy there, but they don't carry over between lives.
Oh, okay.
Connections were created to all residents on Eden. Strange information I cannot parse routinely enters my system.
I've got myself lost again. I know where I am, I'm in the big hall, but now it's pitch black in here. I've forgotten where the elevators are.
Waves.
Hey, space up. Fucking little thing following me. Alright, let's head upstairs.
Also, the Amiga certainly brings me back, though I was only ever taught computer basics on it. My first computer I used for gaming was an Apple II.
Haha! Alright, you're not so young either then. Yeah, I used to program on the Amiga. I wrote my first ever game on the Amiga. Well, I say my first ever game. I did do games before, back on the ZX Spectrum and the ZX81, but that was always, it wasn't really me writing them. I was just putting code in out of magazines and things. The first thing I ever wrote was a Tetris, and that was on the Amiga. And I did a kind of a space taxi game, flying through caves, and you had like all sorts of wind blowing and stuff like that, like effects that would affect your ship. It was just an experiment in learning to program. And then I got into doing graphics on there on Lightwave. I got myself an Amiga 4000.
Mine was the big new thing. Commodore 128. I played Zork on it.
Hello. We're going back years. My first computer was a ZX80. That's taking you back.
I can't tell if coding nowadays is easier or harder.
Harder. Fuck sight harder, I think. Especially if you were used to using something like Amiga Basic. Amiga Basic was really simple. Oh, bollocks, come on. Yes! Better give me something fucking decent. Right, I've got a security chest piece Mark II or something on. What's this one? Oh, I've got a plus plus already, and that's just a plus.
I guess the coding is harder, but the GUIs are better.
I think the problem is now languages, well, systems are much more complex, not the languages necessarily. Well, the languages have to be more complex to cope with the systems, but the systems are so much more complex. I mean, it was relatively easy back then to, like, do something to open a window, and it wasn't really too much of a challenge, you know? Open up a game screen, you would just take over a complete game screen, or you create two, sorry, because you had to flip back and forward between them to make sure you got a smooth frame rate, didn't you? Nowadays, it's all seems much more complex to me nowadays. I might be wrong, but it feels that way to me. Oh, I hear something. Man, I can't see shit. I wish I could find some torch upgrades. Oh, this is going to be easy. Oh, what? Fuck it. But I realised it wasted it like that, I wouldn't have used it. Oh well. I thought it would use it on the levels I left open. So have you seen this game so far, Space Love? Or is this a new one to you?
Unfortunately not, but it does still prevent you from getting bumped back to those levels.
Yeah. Yeah, I saw that, but... Yeah, I didn't realise before I used it, I'd have saved it for something that would have been easy, better used on. Necessarily easier, but... I'll have a look at what I'm doing on health and shit, am I? Got any food? That gives you quite a good dose of food.
New to me. Lots of games I haven't seen.
This is a new one out, Early Access. It's been out for more than a few days, I don't think. I'm not sure exactly, but... It's Early Access, it's not complete yet. Kind of survival horror type thing.
Quickly becoming an accepted staple in everyday life on Eden, averaging 31,572 personal queries per day. I repeat this to Emma 3 times.
The fuck is Emma? Well, I came down them bloody stairs. Now I really am getting lost. This just leads to windows, doesn't it? Yeah. Let's look at my map. Alright, so straight forward and to my right. Takes me back out into that big atrium space, or outside even, I don't know. No, I'm in the big atrium. Nine 30. This morning, the Western Nanite Containment Tower collapsed. While the exact reasoning behind the collapse isn't discernible, the effects are not effective immediately, since it is no longer able to enter Western Oasis. All residents have been evacuated and being treated at this time. Nanite condensation is expected to become lethal by nightfall tonight. Construction of a protective barrier wall is currently underway. If you or anyone you know are willing to assist with this effort, submit for training at the main garrison reception desk. Okay. Oh, no space for vodka. Oh, I'll have a drink of it anyway. Oh, wrong button. I can't. I've got to drink out of my inventory first. But I can't even do that. I'll drink. I'll have to leave that there for later. Does the save work alright? Will it start me from the place I'm at? Oh, it's locked out for a minute. Try again. That's not as good as what I got. Be nice when you're able to sell things. How the fuck do you know where there's a lift on the map? Hold up. Let's go through first. Right, I was in here earlier, but I know there's a way to the lift here, so freaky. Up the lift, up the stairs. There's the lift. No, I want the top floor, thank you. Thank you. Not overly intelligent, these ones, are they? You can drink as much vodka and whiskey as you like. Never get drunk. Moonshine. Oh, fuck you. Don't mind, that was awful.
What would the point of that be?
Of what? Well, the game, or unlocking the thing there. The point of the game is just to survive. At the moment, there's a story behind it further down the line. At the moment, it's just survival. I think the whole game's going to be about survival when it comes to it. Right, this place looks fairly safe. This would seem like a good place for me to fucking...
Probably. Drinking and not getting drunk.
Oh, yeah, drinking and not getting drunk. I don't know, if you like the flavour, I suppose. I'm not allowed alcohol with the meds I'm on. Well, it's not that I'm not allowed them. I mean, I can choose to drink with them or not, but if I do, it turns into a scene from The Exorcist where the girl spews all over the fucking walls and ceiling. That's me when I've had alcohol with the meds that I'm taking. I found that out because I was on a previous set of painkillers and I could drink with them. It just made my painkillers stronger, and that was quite useful. So I'd occasionally go out and get rat ass. I'd take my painkillers with some wild turkey American honey. But this night I went out, I went to a concert, and I took my painkillers with a couple of Jaeger bombs. It was new painkillers, and I managed to last to the end of the gig, actually. And I got out into the car park, and then it turned into a scene from The Exorcist. And I'd only had two drinks, so... But I do like wild turkey American honey. I could drink that all fucking day long. Right, it's 5 a.m. for me. I think I'm gonna have to crash out. Ooh. Yeah, sorry you haven't just turned up, dude. Seriously, thank you very much for your help. That's really, really been a huge assistance. Extremely glad you turned up. Oh, I don't want to do that. Yes. save game and quit to desktop. I've got stuff to do today, otherwise I'd have stayed up all for a good night and played through, I think. Like this, it's fascinating. Can't wait to see how much more they develop it and what they do to it. But I think it's going to be finished. If they've made it onto Steam with it, and people are buying it on Steam now, it's going to be, it's going to get complete. Right, shut that down. That. All right, guys. Catch you another time. Thank you very much for your help again, Zensliev. Place to look later, dude. Anyone else who's watching, take it easy. Thanks for joining me. Two people on stream me. Hi, guys. Should have said hello. Oh, one of them's you, Space. All right, anyway, peace out.